had rented a car.
That was a nice car, actually. I like it.
It was a Kia Rio.
Mummy and I were going to go to a bar and just wait for them, and we're just going to watch the game.
We have had the intention and we had the tickets to go to the game.
Do you remember the score?
No, I actually don't know the score.
Do you know who won?
Was it Venezuela?
It's Peru, 1-0.
So bad. I guess that's... Omid would know that.
I think it was actually not that good a game. It might have been a draw or Peru. I think Peru won.
We didn't go to the game.
Yeah, well, that was the whole problem. I didn't know the result because I didn't make it to the game.
Omid, oh, you got no idea. Omid was so mad. He was so mad he didn't get to see the game.
We only had 2 tickets for that game. Omid and I were going to go further out to Playancha. And this is a main road which connects Viña del Mar to Valparaiso, which are basically one same big city.
On the way there, all of a sudden a big banner just comes up in front.
The traffic comes to a halt, and I wasn't very worried because we had time. I think I was the third car which stopped, and we could see that 2 cars further ahead, the students had got out of the university and they had made a blockade. They didn't let the cars go through.
We quickly realized that it was a protest, and I was just like, yeah, it's okay, you know, they were just stopping people, and they were letting people go. So that was fine. And it's like a stadium traffic for me anyway.
We didn't know what happened in the beginning, and one car went through. And then something happened again, and the second car went through. And we were the first car there, stopped by the people.
And we thought, well, that's okay. They're going to stop us for a few minutes, and then we go. But then people start coming out of the cars, starting to arguing things.
I'm starting to getting a bit anxious because I want to get out to this game. But nothing's going on. And then all of a sudden, the traffic starts banking up and it's getting a bit serious.
They didn't have anything against us, but they wanted to make a scene.
And I remember I opened the window and I asked, what are you doing here?
Protesting, this is not fair, and everybody needs to know, nobody's listening to us, Nosana, we are forced to do this to the public so that we know what's happening.
We were just thinking, this is so stupid, why would they stop the traffic for this, because they're not, I don't think they're making their voice heard in a positive way.
These protests have got nothing to do with us, why are they involving us in this whole thing? But anyway, we start talking to them. We're like, yeah, we agree with this, but why can't you let us through?
One of them wanted to let us through, but then they were just like talking.
And we said that we were going to watch this game, so let us go. No way.
Mom went out there and tried to reason with them and tell them, sorry, you know, we've got a game to go.
I went outside of the car, but they were calling me to come inside.
Mum starts talking to people and my dad's getting a bit concerned because, you know, she's got blonde hair, blue eyes, and he seems to think that is the evil, the other side of what they're protesting about.
What are you doing? You're blonde, so they're going to say, oh, you upper class. They don't know you're not from the upper class. So that was a bit risky.
But that is my people. I know them. They were very scared, actually, and... They were like my classmate that I had 30 years ago.
I really meant to say, Marlene, don't get up. I can go out. Look at me. But you look a bit more,
It really, really then escalates when a dog just comes up out of nowhere.
I see a couple of these students who are looking at my front left wheel and looking with a bit of surprise. Oh, look, what's happening? And I start hearing something like this.
The dogs just bit the tire.
Oh no, these are the perros sueltos.
This is not good.
They're like, yeah, sorry, the dog's just bit the tire.
Hey, look at this dog. It's biting the tire. It's biting the tire. Look at this dog.
We start getting a bit concerned like that. That's when we start getting a bit agitated.
So I told the guys, hey guys, I've got to change this. Let me at least get to the, you know, curbside over there. And so they quickly made a couple of, they had their hierarchy. So they spoke, you know, hey, but we have to, no, we can't. No, but look at this, you know, his tire. Okay. Oh, let him go through. Yeah, get out. No, because the tire is flat. That's why we're letting him through.
And just as they decide, all right, fine, we'll let them through. We see this dog and hear that noise.
I see the same guys now looking at my right-hand front. They say, no, again. And it again, I guess what I hear.
At this point, Omid was pretty upset because we're not going to the game anymore.
So it would just... So I got the car.
The car's just going... We managed to drive up onto the curb, I don't know, 50 meters away.
We had to stop because it was completely flat.
Faramarz started to change one of the wheel.
I don't know if it was like safe for us to stop there and the protest was still going on.
Out of nowhere, we start seeing all these people start throwing rocks.
The students had a pile of stones, pebbles, you know, rocks.
Just think that there must be police.
So we were going to be in the crossfire, rocks, and the, what do they call it, these bombas lacrimógenas, the tear gas.
Some of the students, they covered their faces because they don't want to be recognized.
And I thought, oh no, this is going to get ugly now.
Parents, mum told me to get in the car because it was getting quite dangerous. Get Rachel in the car. What are we doing standing outside? And that's when the big, what do they call it, the fire truck. Not fire truck.
They call it wanako. Wanaka is a bit like a camel. It's an animal which spits at you like alpaca type thing.
And the water was coming towards the boys and toward us. And suddenly stopped a little bit before us.
And the students start running. They go past us. And the police, then after them, the police are coming.
You know, this. Cops running past, the cop falls over, it's just pandemonium.
And the noise that you could hear, it was a very strong noise. They were not walking, they were marching.
Oh my God, this just got very serious.
And I think everybody feel a little bit scared.
You know, we could have got injured, there could have been rocks thrown at us.
This escalated quickly.
Fortunately, nothing went wrong with us, but it was quite a scene.
We were shocked. That is the. We were in shock.
How are we going to fix this? It's not change the flat tire because we only got one spare.
We were trying to figure out how to change the tires because by that time everything was closed.
I thought I take one of these wheels. Go and repair them so that I can come back, change the exchange, and then get the spare with the spare tire, and then at least get somewhere so that the day after I could fix up everything. I went to the other side, couldn't find a taxi.
One of the police with a motorbike then came next to us, and he said, oh, are you guys okay? And then they started chatting.
When I come back, it's Marlene. And Rachel and Omid, they're talking to a police officer.
He was very nice. The nicest police I can remember in Chile.
That guy was an absolute legend. Enjoyed his company, so that was pretty good.
And the police came and asked us, are you guys all right? Did they throw rocks at you? You hurt? And I said, no, we're good. Obviously not to me, to Omid and Mom, because I don't speak Spanish.
He asked for some help.
We need some help. We have some guests here, some tourists.
And another big band came and offered their help to take Faramarz with one of the tires and go to the one of these garage and repair it.
And about 3 minutes later, the police, this thing comes in. That's the type of car that they use when they want to arrest somebody.
But Dad was gone for ages. It must have been at least 2 hours.
I was in the back and I felt like, oh, I'm being arrested. One of the guys, the senior guy, was he was into readings. You could sense that he wanted to know about it. And said, oh, you're from Iran, Imperio Persa, Imperio Persa. Persian Empire. I know about it. It was very big and it was very important. You guys were very advanced. Yes. So the architecture and all of this, and then the driver was, is that true that you can have four wives? And then the senior said, shut up. Don't listen to him. He doesn't know much.
All the places are closed at that time. And Faramarz came back with the same flat tire.
The police officers were still there talking to Mom and Omid and Rachel. And I said, look, we don't have this. We called for one of these vehicles which comes, and it just took the car away to the site where I had rented it from.
We saw the team bus. It was so funny.
We saw the bus with all the players, and we say bye.
Even the team bus has driven past, and our cars not even towed away.
Peru! I'd seen the team bus go to the game. I'd seen the team bus return, and we were still there. So anyway, at least we got to see the team bus.
Okay, where do we want to go now? And then I might as well just go to that bar.
To a place called Liberty, which is a small little bar.
Where they play Cueca Chora.
Liberty, actually, it's called Liberty, not Libertad. Liberty, the name of the pub.
We went to see this Cueca Chora. And we had a great time.
So we went to that bar and then we were just drinking.
And we had chicha and we relaxed, we forgot about the car. We got a taxi to go to that pub and we told him what happened to us. And he said,
was it a white dog?
Yes.
Oh, that bloody dog. He does. So it's a known dog who goes around and does this.
I'm not going to buy a Rio, Kia Rio. If a dog can make a dent or bite into the wheels, what is it? I mean, huh?
Things change. I don't think he
is that true that you can have four wives?
Can't get more Chilean than that.
I know.
We've had pisco sour.
Pisco sour.
Good timing.
Yeah.
Well, I think we'll leave it at that.